everyone, Vanessa Hogle here. I thought I would do a quick video blog, but might not be that quick. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. Okay. I actually got this idea from kind of a strange place. Not just wanting to help people, but the idea just it came from a conversation that I just had with a friend of mine. I had stopped by her house for a minute and went to talk to her about something, and another friend was there, and they were asking me questions about the dental industry because I've been in it for 18 years. So, and the conversation got into some things that they had been told, and some offers that had been made to them for treatment, and I went through the list and noticed kind of what I consider padding, you know, maybe not necessarily necessary stuff. And so I highly encouraged her to get a second, third, fourth, fifth opinion. And it got me to thinking that we don't really have something like this in the paranormal field. You know, and it's, boy, would it be nice, you know, I mean, it'd be pretty necessary, I think. Got me to thinking that it might be good to give y'all some tips or viewpoints, ideas, whatever you want to call it, about how to spot fakers, okay? I guess it's all, like I said, it's all about helping people, and I would really like to do that. And I've had so many people come to me with readings. I've written blogs on it. One poor person came to me and was talking about how they were told they had been cursed, and that the person could lift their curse for, you know, to the tune of like $500 or $700. I got so fucking livid, I got so mad, because that bullshit is what fucks it up for the rest of us. For those who are doing this for the right reasons, whether you're a team, an individual, a psychic, an investigator, whatever, it's those people that really make this unbelievably difficult to be in. And by the way, I apologize, you know, I worked all day, I'm tired. This is as good as y'all are gonna get. So, I mean, it's clean. Does that help? I don't know. Yeah, ponytail all day. Hey. so, sorry. That's again, squirrel. But I just, it hurts my heart to know that is happening to people out there. And I'm trying not to cry while I do this because I get so angry about it. I start crying, you know. But I would just like to give people, you know, an idea of what to look for. I have been in the presence of particular psychics who I knew what they were doing. I'm just gonna say it, you know. I knew what they were doing. I knew it was a bunch of bullshit. I knew it was big old fake fest. Okay. I wished at those times that I might have said something to the individual they were reading for, but it wasn't one I was involved in. And on the off chance that I was wrong, I wanted to stay clear and just hope that the person would wise up to what was happening. So without further ado, here are these things that you need to look out for. First off, anyone whom I've ever read for, if I've read for you in person, excuse me, again with the burping, every fucking time I get on this thing, I start burping. I don't know why. Okay, so I guess y'all like it because you keep watching, so bless you. But anyone whom I've ever read for in person knows that, especially if I'm doing a tarot reading, I don't look at you. I will avoid eye contact every way possible. If I don't have to look at you, I won't. because I don't want any thing that you do, any twitch of the eye, any intake of the breath, the change in your posture, I don't want any of that to affect what I'm seeing in the cards, because it shouldn't. The cards are the cards, regardless of what's going on over here, you know. But I don't want to see something and subconsciously have it change what I'm reading. So, if you're having a card reading from somebody and you're face to face, do whatever you can to make it, even if it means having them face away from you, because there really is no need to look at you. Okay, there just isn't. Have it to where you're facing away from them, and they're reading you. You know, or have them face away from you, even better. Because if they're looking at your back, they might see, you know, you tense up or whatnot. And we don't want that. Do whatever you can to make it be as blind of a reading as possible, if you're going to go that route. The other thing, be very, very wary of people telling you unbelievably negative things. Now, if you know you've got some negative shit going on, or it's coming at you, or you expect it in the future, it's one thing. But there is something that people do when they sell readings. They want to keep you coming back. It's kind of like an unlicensed therapist. It's kind of what it's like, you know. Didn't have to go to school for it. So, you know, but they want you to keep coming back. They want to give you something that makes you need them. And that's where I get lost. That's where I get a little bit angry, because it's really the other way around. They need you. You need to realize that, because, you know, if they're making a living off of it, which plenty of valid and, you know, good psychics can make a living at this, but they make a living with a lot of different clients. They don't have to rely on the same client coming back every 2 weeks or every 4 weeks or every 6 weeks, because there really is no need. That's another thing. Y'all, some shit you just ain't supposed to know. Get over it. Okay? We don't know the lottery numbers. Be okay with that. Alright? And if I did, I sure as fuck ain't gonna tell you. You know? Now, if I did and I won, I'd share it with everybody, because I don't give a fuck about money. But we don't know them, okay? You got just as good of a chance of winning that without us as you do with us. Just saying. But you shouldn't have to keep coming back. You shouldn't need to know that much information. If you're willing to waste your money, by all means, have at it. I got better shit to spend my money on, you know. Even if I didn't do this the way that I do it, even if I didn't already know stuff, I'm not gonna do that, you know. Also, I'm sorry, guys. If it's an exorbitant amount of money that they're charging, run. Would you? Okay. Because, sorry, I'm gonna light this real quick. Because there is absolutely no reason in the world to charge somebody $150 or $200 or whatever for a psychic reading. Please, for the love of whatever deity you pray to, don't do that shit. You're condoning this behavior, and it's ridiculous. You know, I mean, it just is. I will say this. I researched a very well-known psychic on TV, and found that she does actually donate, like, her public readings to charity. 100% of the proceeds. I found that out. If anyone can prove me wrong on that, because I know y'all know who I'm talking about, then, you know, by all means, do it. Please prove me wrong. Because I was skeptical, very skeptical about that. I found that out, and I'm like, you know what? More fucking power to her, because she's doing something with it. It's not going to her. So, nothing but love, okay? But those things you need to watch out for. The other thing is if they want to touch you. Now, keep in mind, I know if you're doing a palm reading, that might be something that they have to do. But those are so very rarely accurate. A matter of fact, a dear friend of mine, she and I were down in New Orleans, and she wanted to try it, you know, just to see. And so she went and had her palm read. Couldn't have been further from the fucking truth if it tried. I mean, on every level. True story, okay? So, you might want to shy away from that, okay? And by the way, I can't keep fucking looking at this little light up here. So, y'all just going to have to be okay with me looking all over the place. Because I don't know what to do about that. But yeah, it was comical in its disappointment. I don't know how else to put it. But one thing they do, if they want to touch you, they're checking pulse. They're checking if you're trembling. They're checking the involuntary response of tensing up. Again, what they can visually see with their eyes, they're feeling with their hands. And don't do that. Okay? Don't do that. I'm not saying everyone out there cheats. But I'm saying that the percentage is high enough that you don't want to give them any help. Fair enough? Okay. When it comes to your standard psychic reading as opposed to tarot cards or palm reading, if someone is just doing a psychic reading that has nothing to do with the more witchy aspect of it, then this is where it gets trickier. And I cannot stress this enough. Do not, under any circumstances, if you want an accurate reading, give any information. Or at least give as minimal information as possible. Because somebody who has these abilities, now they're not going to be able to give you every single thing you want. But if they're on the right track, then they're going to get specific information. Okay? Another good thing to do, you can Google this. Find out what the most common first letter to every female name and male name in the United States. You do that, and if that's one that they start spouting off, but they can't give you the name or can't give you anything even close to it. Because there are times when you will get a name that sounds like one name, but is another. But it sounds very, very similar to another name. That can happen. Again, rare, but it can happen. But if they just start saying, well, there's somebody and they've got a name that starts with J. No fucking shit, Sherlock. They're all over the place. You know, I mean, come on. Give me something different. If you're going to do that, you better fucking back it up with what they look like, how tall they are. Are they a male? Are they female? What's their hair color? What's their eye color? You know, do they have big boobs? Give me something. Okay? Don't just throw out there that I've seen this one so often, it actually makes me gag, okay? You can walk up to somebody of a certain age, and you can look at them, and you can get this look on your face, because I've seen it done. I swear I want to pimp slap a bitch when I see this, where they walk up, and they just touch them on the shoulder, and they say, oh, darling, don't be mad at me. But your grandmother would be so proud of you. And of course the person starts bawling because they're of a certain age. Let's say myself, I'm 45. obviously, my grandparents are deceased. So if I didn't know what I know, that would really affect me. And I'm not even saying that it isn't true sometimes. But you could not pick a more generic statement to say to somebody of a certain age. You just couldn't. So if they can't give you specifics, if they can't give you information that is not readily available, if it seems as if they're trying to fish for information from you, then you need to run. And don't pay a fucking dime for it, okay? That's what I tell people when they send me something. They'll say, well, I need a reading from you. And this is the few and far between I can even do them anymore because I don't have the fucking time. I'm sorry. Especially got to get this damn book out, you know. But they'll say, what do I need to tell you? And I'm like, not a fucking thing. Nothing. Tell me nothing. I want no information. I'll tell you everything I get. And then once I'm done, then you can start adding your stuff in and tell me where it's valid and where it isn't. And if it isn't valid at all, that's okay. I'm only telling you what I got. So, matter of fact, I was one of the weeks, a year and a half ago or something, I think I did 65 free, mind you, readings in a week while working two jobs, being a mother. I think this was actually this might have been before Walking with Ghosts came out. I don't know. Could have been. Anyway, either way, fucking busy, okay? But I did 65 readings in 1 week. And when I say 1 week, I mean Monday through Friday. Didn't even toss the weekends in there. And I had one that I was doing where I was talking to the girl, and I mean, this was all through DM on Twitter. And this is before I learned how to say no. I'm too tired. I'm too busy. And I told her everything I had, and one thing didn't add up for her. And that was the fact that all I could see was this, like, gourmet-style kitchen, you know? And that the guy was in the kitchen cooking us, making some really delicious-looking food. Let's just go ahead and say it, you know? Again, Southern gal. I like food, so peace out. But it didn't make any sense to her, which is okay. Because he's who I saw in my living room. He's who had stepped in towards the end of that reading. Well, I had no way of knowing at that time that he was for the reading I hadn't started yet that was directly after her. So, I wasn't going to change my reading based on what she said, and I told her that. I said, I'm seeing this guy. I said, everything else matches. For whatever reason, he doesn't. So, I said, you can disregard him, but I can't, you know. I can't disregard him because he's here. And so, he ended up being for the next person, which I thought was really freaking cool, because that was the first time that had ever happened like that. So yay for a first. And the other thing, like when there have been times when I've read for NP Paranormal out of England, and I will give them my reading, never knowing where they're going. Don't have a fucking clue. They don't tell me first. Matter of fact, I find out when they get there. How funny is that? They specifically do their live stream pictures in a way to not even give any idea as to where they're going. And it's funny because on quite a few occasions, and Dave's writing something about this up for the book, on quite a few occasions I've given them a reading and they're like, man, I don't know where you're going with this, but I, you know, and they'll get, apparently, and this is all in England, so I'm not there for this. God, what the fuck is going on with that? Oh, I really need to brush it. But they'll get to where they're going. They can't get in, so they'll change locations without me knowing, and my reading fits the location that they went to next. I have no way of knowing. They have no way of knowing. Yet there it is. So, you know, don't discount every bit of information that's given to you. But always question every bit of information that's given to you. Don't blindly assume that just because somebody, including myself, says that they're psychic or has certain abilities, don't automatically assume that we know everything, that we're truthful, or even that we're honest. And any person out there who does this should never have a problem being questioned. I have preached and preached and preached that till I am blue in the fucking face. And I will continue to do so. Because I'm so sick and tired of seeing people get taken advantage of. This isn't something that you can look up in the phone book and find a reputable person. So much of it depends on word of mouth. Well, if you feel like it hasn't worked out for you, or that you might have been bamboozled, we'll say that. I like that word, bamboozled. I don't even know if it fits, but we'll just go with it. Speak up. Speak up about it. It's okay. You know, don't assume that you're going to sound ridiculous because you paid for a psychic reading. Or didn't pay. Who knows? Don't assume that you're going to sound ridiculous for that. I was ever so thankful that the person that came to me about that curse thing felt comfortable enough to be able to do that. Because a lot of people would have probably laughed her in the face. Or the wrong person would have agreed with it, but charged her a little bit less money. That should scare you. Oh, and by the way, like I put it in my blog, my written blog, that's called extortion. Did you know that? Mm-hmm. If you look it up, extortion is the receiving of monies or something of value from a person based on a threat. I'm paraphrasing, but you know what I mean. So, to tell a person that they are cursed and that you're the only one who can fix it, and they got to pay you for it, well, that's extortion in my book. Because you're inciting fear, which is a threat. And then you're trying to make money off of it, which is receiving money. So, it might be a leap in the court of law, but in the court of Vanessa, I think you're a fucking asshole. Don't do it. So, anyway, I'm trying to think of anything else I was going to tell y'all about that. Just remember, just to recap, try to have a reading if you're doing it face-to-face where you're not looking at each other. Have them turn their backs. I would have absolutely no problem doing a reading for someone if they're facing my back and I can't see them at all. You know, because there's nothing wrong with that, you know. As far as touching, remember, try not to touch. Don't let them touch you during the reading. Don't let them feel your pulse. Don't let them feel you shake. Don't let them feel any of that. If they're going to get something, they're going to get it without that. There is no need. When it comes to a psychic reading, which doesn't have anything to do, like I said, with a palm reading or tarot, be very, very, very wary of vague information. Okay? Anybody can do that. Anybody. So if they can't give you specifics, and I'm not saying they need to be able to recite your entire family history or location or dates, but they gotta give you something. And it better be pretty fucking accurate. You know? Don't fall for the, "Well, I see wonderful things in your future, darling." I do. I do. I see wonderful things. You're just going to have to be patient. Don't fall for that bullshit. That's not a fucking reading. That's a statement. It's not prophetic. It's something they're just saying to you. Okay? I can't be more specific than that. I really can't. Always, 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 always question. Question me. Question anybody out there who's doing this. We need you people. I don't think you know that. And I'm really trying to make you understand it. We need you. We need people who believe in us. But we need to give you a reason to believe in us. You need to keep us humble and keep us in our tracks, keep us square. So, if y'all can think of anything I missed, by all means, tell me, put it in the little comments below, okay? And I'll come back to it. I'll check it out if you have any questions on it, okay? Just toss it on in there, all right? Now, you know how weird I am trying to hit this pause button, so I'm just going to go ahead and do that right now, but I love y'all. Yeah, where's the pause button? Here it is.